Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to continue working on fractional equations, and we're going to work on those in word problem form. So begin with the question stated above. One third of a number. Well, one third, we know we can write that as a number. We know the word of means to multiply. And since we don't know what the number is, we're going to put that in as an x. The word is means equal. 6 more, so I'm going to put plus 6, so I'm going to leave some space. 6 more than 1 fourth, so I can write 1 fourth. I see the word of, which again means to multiply, of the number. And again, we know that the number is just x. And just to make my order of operations clear, I'm going to put parentheses in here showing that the 1 fourth is being multiplied by the x before it's being incremented or added 6 more. All right, so now we have our fractional equation. Next, let's find our LCD. I have a denominator of 3 and a denominator of 4, so my LCD is 12. So we're going to list 12, and I know 1 third times x is x over 3. I'm going to set that equal to 12 times 1 fourth times x is x over 4. Plus 6, and remember this 12 has to be distributed to all the terms in your equation. That's why the x fourths plus 6 is in parentheses. Now let's multiply or distribute the 12. 12 times x thirds is 12x over 3. Set that equal to 12 times x over 4 plus 12 times 6, which is 72. Now I need to simplify my fractions. 12 divided by 3 leaves me with a 4x. And then 12x divided by 4 leaves me with 3x. And I rewrite my 72. I need to get my variables off to one side. So I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. I see the 3x goes away over there. 4x minus 3x just leaves me x. And my 72 comes down. So I find that the value of the number is 72. Now I need to check my work to make sure that is correct. In doing the check, I'm going to substitute 72 into these x values in my original equation. So here I have 1 third of 72 is equal to 1 fourth of 72 plus 6. Well, to the left, 72 thirds is equal to 72 fourths plus 6. 3 goes into 72 24 times, and then here I see that 4 goes into 72. 4 goes into 7 one time. This should be a 3. So 4 goes into 72 18 times. Then I write my 18 plus 6. Now I evaluate on my right hand side. 18 plus 6 is in fact 24. So I see that my calculations are correct, that the unknown value is 72. All right, that sums it up for this video from Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the name Speller Tutorial. Thank you again for watching.